I'm Adam Collins. This is a Crick Buzz Centre Stage here at the Oval. When the World Cup 2019 fixtures were released, you would have looked at Bangladesh and New Zealand in the second week of the tournament and maybe didn't think much of it. It wouldn't have been a high-profile fixture, but I assure you, it's a very tasty game coming up here at Wednesday. The day-night game at the Oval behind me here, New Zealand are training at the moment under lights. New Zealand, phenomenal in their first up showing against Sri Lanka, especially with the ball. As for Bangladesh, they couldn't have played a better game against South Africa in their campaign opener on Sunday at this very ground. There's plenty of history between these sides as well. They play each other a lot. There's a very nice rivalry. They play each other in both countries. Indeed, 2 years ago during the Champions Trophy, it was Bangladesh that eliminated New Zealand, chasing down about 270 over in Cardiff. That was a famous day when Shakib Al-Hassan and Mahmudullah both made wonderful hundreds after Bangladesh were reduced to about 50 for five. So they've got form in this country as well. So it should be the sort of contest where whoever comes out of this with two wins and no losses will have, I wouldn't say one foot in the semi-final, but they're beautifully positioned to go through the draw knowing they have a base laid. The New Zealand camp have an enormous amount of respect for Bangladesh, but they know they have some very, very good fast bowlers as well. Lockie Ferguson hit the radar at 92 mile an hour in the old money on Saturday. Trent Bolt, of course, one of the best swing bowlers in the world. Matt Henry in tremendous nick as well.
I think we've played Bangladesh a lot over the last couple of seasons. So we sort of know how they go about things. And in recent tournaments, they've obviously played really well over in the Champions Trophy a few years ago, and then obviously their game here a few days ago. So we know what threats they have in their side, but hopefully we can stick to the things that we do well and keep going on the momentum that we built up a few days ago.
As for Bangladesh, who knows? They came through their opening game against South Africa in such high spirits and unscathed as far as injury is concerned. They know this ground well. They know these conditions well. They know their opponent well too. They're every chance to go two and zip, and then who knows?
First of all, the win over South Africa. I mean, I came to the England-South Africa game. I watched every ball bowled. I scouted it. I was delighted with the surface, what I saw, and I was delighted when I couldn't really see another pitch cut out, and I had a hunch that we might be playing on the same pitch. When I found that out the next day in practice, I was delighted. I thought that was a great opportunity for Bangladesh to try and take South Africa. We needed them to maybe have a slightly off day and us play very well, and those, that sort of thing happened on the day. It'll be a really big challenge tomorrow against New Zealand on a fresh pitch, and a more difficult challenge than South Africa was on that pitch. Has it changed our sort of goals? Well, we know we need to get so many wins to qualify. We're not bothered who the wins come against. We've just got to make sure we get those wins, and they'll all be difficult. You know, New Zealand will be difficult. South Africa was difficult, but we managed to pull that one off. So the goals remain the same. We just want to try and take every game as it comes. I know it's a cliche, but you can't get too far ahead and think too far ahead. We've just got to get wins on the board, and whatever game comes up, the objective is to try and win that game.
What we do know for sure is that the Oval under lights, the crowd will be magnificent. The Bangladesh support was huge the other day. They've actually bought 8% of the tickets for the whole tournament. That's more tickets than the Australian fans have bought, would you believe? So it'll be a great contest to watch. We can't wait to bring it to you on Crick Buzz Centre Stage. I'm Adam Collins. We'll talk to you then.